This video, Article Magic, covers sections 45, 46, and 47 in Hansen and Quinn's Greek, an intensive course, and it covers the substantive use of the article and the articular infinitive. You can find this information in Hansen and Quinn on pages 125 to 128, and in the appendix on pages 698, 723, and 758. The article in Greek has really remarkable qualities. Anything that you can put into attributive position, that is to say, anything that you can have an article in front of, can become substantive, can turn into people or things through article magic. So if you give something a masculine article, it creates a man or men. If you give something a feminine article, it creates a woman or women. And if you give it a neuter article, it creates a thing or things. Up until now, we've said hoi ente agora anthropoi to mean the men in the marketplace, with hoi as our article, with anthropoi as the noun men, and ente agora in attributive position to help us specify which men. But Greek's article is so magical that we can take off anthropoi and just leave the hoi, and we still have the men in the marketplace. This works as well for hai ente agora. The feminine plural article, all on its own, will give us women. So that's the women in the marketplace. Similarly, ta ente agora, the neuter article, will give us the things in the marketplace. So Greek can have a sentence, hoi nun lousi tas apotes nesu, which has many more people in it than it has nouns. Hoi nun in the nominative means the men now. Tas apotes nesu means in accusative the women from the island. And so the translation would be the men now free lousi tas apotes nesu, the women from the island. And we don't have to use anthropoi with hoi nun to say the men, and we don't even have to know the word for woman yet to be able to say tas apotes nesu, the women from the island. We do this in English as well. Only the good die young. We don't need to say only the good men or the good people die young. We can simply use the English article the and the modifier good to know that we mean the category of people that who are good. And in Greek, that would be hoi kaloi. In English, we can say no rest for the wicked. And we could do that in Greek the way we do it in English without a noun to be people or men or women and say tois kakois for the wicked. So with a masculine article and an adjective that agrees, you're going to get in the singular, a singular man, the good man. With a feminine article, it will be hei agathe, the good woman. With a neuter article, it will be to agathon, the good thing. This can also be the concept, the whole general idea of the good. And so Greek's article and this ability of the article to make substantive modifiers and concepts is one of the reasons why Greek is a very good language to do philosophy in. In the plural, of course, in all the cases, not just the nominative that you see here, you can have the good men. Even without an article, even though we're talking about the substantive use of the article, the plural of an adjective, if it's masculine and you don't have a noun for it to be modifying, is still going to be good men. And you can see that quite often with adjectives when they aren't modifying a particular noun. In the plural, agatha can mean good things or goods. And when you do the neuter plural, It can be the things of war, sort of the materials of war, or it can be more the conceptual things that go with war. So perhaps the affairs of war. And you'll see in Hansen and Quinn and in Greek in the Wild that ta gets used to generalize that way quite a bit to mean the affairs. So there are some little nitty-gritty details that make this even more fun. Super cool details that only Greek is really capable of. With men and da, our good old friends that can give us a contrast on the one hand or on the other hand, you can put just the article with the men and the da and get ha men, ha da, to mean the one and the other. And it's easiest to see how this works when I give you an example. Ha men pempe, ha da thue, which is going to mean the one sends, the other sacrifices. So one man sends, but another man sacrifices is sort of the fullest way to say that. It doesn't have to be in the nominative. Tas men didaskomen, tas de thoptomen would mean some we teach, others we bury. Or if you want to get all of the idea that's implied in that feminine accusative plural article, then you would say, we teach some women, but we bury others. And even in English, we don't necessarily fill out the whole idea with repeating the word women. We also abbreviate, don't use the words that we don't need, and say we bury others instead of saying we bury other women. So Greek can do that with men and da and the super cool magical article. Another detail that we can get in Greek has to do with the negative. So first let me talk about the positive. Hoi kakoi can mean the bad men. That is to say, specific bad men, perhaps those bad men over there, or the bad men that we've been talking about. But it can also mean bad men, the whole category of men who are bad. In the positive, it means both of those things, and that would be true with hoi agathoi, hoi axioi, the worthy men that we've been talking about, perhaps, or the entire category of worthy men. When it's positive, you don't have a way to tell, except from context, whether you're being specific or general. But Greek has two different negatives. So, hoi ouk kakoi is specific not bad men, the not bad men that we've been talking about, or the not bad men right over there. But if you use me, hoi me kakoi, then you are definitely talking about not bad men in general, the whole category of men who are not bad. And that is something that, because Greek has two different negatives, it can show you in its super cool Greek details the difference between those two ways of talking about specific people or general idea of people. So that's a small detail. And of course, you only get it when the concept happens to be negative. But there it is for you to know the difference if you do run into those. Okay, so another thing the article can do is go with an infinitive to make verbal nouns useful in a sentence. So first, let's remember what we can already do with infinitives. So here's grapheme, the present active infinitive of grapho, write. And so far, we have used that to mean to write. And we've used it to complete the meaning of certain verbs. So when we command someone to do something, we need an infinitive to complete that meaning. So keleuomen tous adelphus biblia graphein. We command keleuomen the brothers tous adelphus to write graphein biblia books. We also use the infinitive to complete the meaning of other words like adjectives. So, epempsamen tus poietas tus axius graphein. We sent the poets, which poets? The ones worthy to write or worthy of writing. So, we've used the infinitive that way as well to complete the meaning of certain adjectives where you need a little bit extra information that's a verbal idea. But I think when I introduced infinitives to start with, I told you that they are in fact verbal nouns. But the thing about nouns in Greek is that you need to know what case they are to use them in a sentence. Well, the article, in all of its magicalness, gives the infinitive, which of course only has one form, it gives it case. So if we need to say the concept of writing, the idea of writing, the noun writing is noble, all we have to do is give grapheme a neuter article, and then we can use it as a sentence. So here it is, neuter nominative singular with grapheme, and now we can use it in a sentence. To grapheme kalon, writing is noble. Or you could also say, to write is noble. We can also have it used with other cases. So before writing, we need the article pra, and then we put the article in the neuter article in the genitive, and here I've used the aorist infinitive, before writing pra to grapsai. Now the verbal noun, the infinitive, has case, and so we can use it in every place that we would use a noun. Pra to grapsai, before writing. If we needed to say by means of writing, that is to say a dative of means, all we have to do is give it a dative neuter article, and then we have dative of means with our infinitive. And similarly, it can be accusative. So on account of having written dia and the accusative, we would simply give it the neuter accusative article. And here I used the perfect active infinitive to show you that it can work with that as well. On account of having written dia ta gegraphenai. If you need to make the concept negative, then you're going to use me. And so kakon ta me graphein means not writing is bad. Ta me graphein is kakon. So this is what Greek has instead of a gerund. Greek does not have a gerund form. Greek uses the articular infinitive whenever it needs to use a verbal noun in a sentence and so that it has case. So Greek doesn't have a gerund. This is what you do instead. And there you have it. Article magic, the substantive use of the article, and the articular infinitive. And you ought to be able to use those things in sentences now and see how economical and magical Greek is.